The manger is now three decades past. Jesus entered the world on a starry, silent night. Now, as he prepares to enter the holy city, surrounded by shouts of praise and adoration, he knows what lies ahead. He knows that soon, those same people will shout condemnations and call for his death on the cross. He fully recognizes the task ahead. There is a debt to be paid, and he is prepared to pay it in full.
For 3 years, Jesus healed the sick, the blind, and the lame. He fed thousands with a few pieces of bread and a few fish. He raised the dead, and he forgave the worst sinners. He challenged those within his own religion who preached hate and division.
He taught others that the Father does love us, and that we too should love and accept others unconditionally. He revealed to us a loving and merciful God.
Through the birth of his son, Jesus, God did open the eyes of our hearts, and through the crucifixion, he opened the gate of heaven for you and for me.
Joy and splendor of heaven.
Jesus, his disciples, and their followers walk the dusty road that leads straight into Jerusalem. It's a road they have traveled before, but not like this, not riding on a donkey with crowds pressing in on every side. Hosanna in the highest. Make room for Jehovah. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna to the Son of David.
This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee. Hosanna in the highest.
Jesus entered the city among shouts of adoration and praise. He went to the temple and threw out those who were buying and selling there. He healed the blind and the lame.
Then he left the city and went to Bethany. In the days that followed, he told his followers many parables and spoke of the end time. He stated, "No one knows about that day or hour, not even the angels of heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father."
When Jesus was tested by the Pharisees, he called them hypocrites and told the people to obey them, but not to act like them. Then when he was asked, "What is the greatest commandment?" Jesus replied, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind." Hearing this, the chief priest plotted to arrest Jesus in some sly way and kill him. Judas, one of the 12, went to the chief priests and said, "What are you willing to give me to betray him to you?"
Thirty pieces of silver, the price of a slave. That's all he got for the master's life. They weighed out each piece, handed it to Judas, and in turn, Judas would turn Jesus over with a kiss. The seeds of betrayal were planted in the heart of Judas long before that night. How can we justify the life of our Savior for just 30 pieces of silver? What can we say to thank him for his sacrifice, for the pain and the punishment he endured to give us eternal life? How can we thank him for being such a friend?
It is Jesus' last night with his disciples. They had shared their last meal together. Then Jesus got up from the table and washed the disciples' feet. The master washing their feet? Jesus acting as a servant? Maybe he was setting an example for all of us to remember, to humbly serve one another. But this was just the beginning of his lessons on that last night together.
This was Passover. It was supposed to be a celebration, but it didn't seem like one. Then Jesus talked about his blood and his body. Was this not the same cup, not the same bread they had always shared? This was something new, unfamiliar.
My body given for you, he said. My blood poured out for you, he said. He gave it. He gave it all. He knew what would happen. He knew what he was doing. It was at this table that they saw the truth. Jesus loved them. He loves all of us with a mighty love, a love bigger than anything the world has ever known, a love that surpasses all human understanding, all because of the wonderful cross.
Thank you.
night they were together, Jesus told the disciples, "It's been prophesied, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will scatter." Peter replied, "Even if all fall away account of you, I never will." "I tell you the truth," Jesus answered, "Simon, Simon Peter, before the rooster crows today, yes, tonight, before he crows twice, you will disown me three times."
When Jesus was arrested, the disciples did desert him and flee. And when Peter was confronted, he too denied Jesus three times before the cock crowed, as Jesus had predicted. They betrayed him as surely as Judas did. Judas did it for silver. They did it for free. What had they done? They abandoned Jesus when he needed them most.
Then Jesus fulfilled his divine destiny. He was brought before the Roman and religious leaders. When Herod asked the crowds to choose Jesus or Barabbas, they shouted, "Jesus! Crucify him! Crucify him!" He was beaten and scourged by the Roman guards as they prepared him for execution. Three nails and a cross. "Hail the King of the Jews," they mocked.
Through his wounds, we are saved. Through his suffering, we were taught to love. Behold the Lamb of Glory.
Sacrifice most holy.
They brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, the place called the skull. Then they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. Then they crucified him. They crucified two robbers with him, one on his right and one on his left.
As Jesus hung on the cross, the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the elders mocked him, saying, "He saved others, but he can't save himself. Let him come down now from the cross, and we will believe in him." At the sixth hour, darkness came over the land until the ninth hour. Then Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani? My God, why have you forsaken me?"
Then Jesus cried out in a loud voice and he gave up his spirit. The cross, the very instrument of his death, now became the symbol of our eternal life. The crown of thorns, the instrument of his suffering, became the golden symbol of how far God was willing to go to redeem us. If there was no cross for him, there is no crown for us.
Thank you.
It is very early on the first day of the week. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb where Jesus was buried. When they arrived, she found that the stone had been rolled away and his body was gone. She ran back and found Peter and John. Together, they returned to the tomb and found strips of cloth lying there and the burial cloth folded up by itself. Mary stayed behind, and it is then that she encountered Jesus. Thinking that he was the gardener, she asked him where her master's body was. Jesus said to her, "Mary." And she turned to him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. What great happiness! With it, she ran back to where the disciples were hiding. Can you imagine her joy and excitement?
Imagine her knocking on the door where the disciples and followers were gathered. "Simon, John, it's Mary. Hurry, open the door. I have seen him. Our master, I have seen him. I stayed after you left. I wanted to just be near him. Do you hear me? I've seen him, Peter. He's alive. Jesus is alive. He is risen. He is risen indeed."
King Jesus, King Jesus.
because he lives, our joy is complete.
Jesus came, he lived, he died, and he rose to redeem us.
He promised through the prophets that he would come to us, and he did.
He promised through his own word that he would never leave us, that he would be with us every moment of every day, and he is here with us now.
He promised to come back and take us to be with him forever, and indeed he will come.
Yes, Jesus, our friend and Savior, has earned our love and devotion, and we will worship him now and forever.
Jesus is sovereign.
Jesus is majestic.
He is with us.
He is Lord.
Let heaven and earth rejoice.
Let everything that has breath praise him.
Yeah, please remain standing. Please remain standing. Thank you, choir, and our tech team and all who helped bring this great cantata. Don has a special gift to offer to Joe. Thank you, Joe, for all your wonderful leadership and directorship. What a great message to begin Holy Week as we move on towards Easter. But let's receive our benediction at this time. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And may the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace, his promises, his power and his presence, and his love. Go to love God and to love others and to serve the world in Jesus' name. Amen. God be with you.